Here's the man.
Now, you see, this is Guillaume de Gerfagnon, amongst his books. But of course, I mean, this photograph was taken here at the Orientale, not in Turkey. This is the time when he was called up to Rome by the Jesuit, the Father General, in order to start teaching on archaeology and the history of the empire. And that was, I may be mistaken, but I think it was 1917, 1918. He was right at the beginning, one of the first professors in this institute.
You have to look at Gerfagnon from a comprehensive perspective. I mean, don't forget, Gerfagnon was a Jesuit. He went to Turkey. For what reason? Because he loved Turkey and because he wanted to do his regency there. He wanted to learn the language. Now, Gerfagnon thought that it was an honest moment of justice towards those people to learn their own language. Why? Because a photograph for him, let's talk about photographs, a photograph for him was to capture a moment of life, a life he personally experienced with the people who had been filmed by him. So it was a moment of science, a moment of religious activity, Jesuit activity, but basically, I mean, I would dare say it was a moment of love. I mean, he loved these people. For God's sake, I mean, they are poor. But please, look at the dignity of this man. Look at the joyfulness springing from the faces of these girls. Look at the serious attitude, the attire of this girl, and the background is a Roman column and a Byzantine wall. So that is to put someone within a frame of antiquity, but let her become alive. So that is Gerfagnon.
This seems to be a very interesting time period because it's the beginning of really photography as an art.
Yes.
So he's documenting this. We've got all these different cultures sort of in that transition period between yes. the ancient ways of life, the traditional ways of life, and of course the beginnings of these nation states.
So was living there with all these communities and tribes and religions. And we have a very good correspondence between Gerfagnon in Turkey, in Ankara, and of course, those photographs of Ankara we have is the time when Ankara had just become the capital of Turkey, but it was a village. So this is the upper part of the city, which is the Byzantine citadel, which still stands there, but it's a very poor quarter of this is Ulus, very very poor quarter Ankara. More or less on this around this part of the hill is the archaeological museum, and attached very close to the archaeological museum there is also a lovely small Jesuit house. You see, this is the same citadel but taken from behind the first one. So these are the circuit of walls, Byzantine walls all around, and you see Ankara was situated, set on a hill. There you have again a better close-up part of the walls with towers. You see there is a river here with the young kids swimming. Of course all this part you cannot see it anymore in Ankara because this is a huge part, commercial part of the city. There is a very large highway just crossing the valley on which the citadel is set. You see, what you have, this is the bridge, and the bridge is here. No? So this is the last moment when you still see Ankara. So in a certain way, thanks to Gerfagnon, here and there, we can trace the boundaries of the ancient city.